guys, and welcome back to my channel, and welcome back to my The Skinny On series. So for today's video, I'm going to be chatting all about coffee creamer. So since I know that these coffee creamers are pretty popular, and since I also know that they are highly processed, I thought this would be a good item to feature in these videos, just so I can go over with you guys kind of more in detail, look through the food label, look through the ingredient list, and see what's really going on inside of these little flavored creamers. So if you guys have already seen my other The Skinny On videos, you know that I always actually have the product here in front of me to look at and kind of scrutinize with you guys. So the one that I picked up is this Nestle Coffee Mate Peppermint Mocha flavor, and this is just a regular one. I also wanted to get like a sugar-free one, but I couldn't find any in the store that I was in, unless it was like a giant one and I didn't want to purchase a giant one. So I just ended up getting this one, but I'm also going to pull up a nutrition facts label from a sugar-free Coffee Mate coffee creamer so we can also go over that too. So let's just dive right into it and look at the nutrition facts label. So in one serving of this peppermint mocha coffee creamer, which is one tablespoon, it has 35 calories, 1.5 grams of fat, and 5 grams of sugar, and 5 milligrams of sodium. So not really much, you know, nutrient-wise. It's pretty light, I guess. But what I'm more concerned about looking at is the ingredient list. So the ingredients are as follows in this coffee creamer. Water, sugar, vegetable oil, and then less than 2% of sodium caseinate, natural and artificial flavors, mono and diglycerides, dipotassium phosphate, cellulose gel, cellulose gum, and carrageenan. So not a ton of ingredients, but it's basically just sugar, water that has fat globs added to it, and then just a bunch of stabilizers, thickeners, and preservatives. So that is for the regular one, and then as for the sugar-free kind, which I know is probably pretty popular as well, I don't have one here with me, but I did pull up the nutrition facts. So I have the sugar-free pumpkin spice liquid here in front of me, the nutrition facts label for that creamer. So for one tablespoon or one serving of the pumpkin creamer liquid, it has 15 calories versus 35 in the regular, 1 gram of fat versus 1.5 in the regular, and then 0 grams of sugar. I'm sorry, obviously it's sugar-free. 0 grams of sugar, and the other one had 5. So this obviously is a little bit lighter, a couple less calories, but I mean 20 calories, it's like nothing. But then again, most importantly, the ingredients for the sugar-free liquid is water, corn syrup — corn isn't everything — vegetable oil, maltodextrin, mono and diglycerides, dipotassium phosphate, natural and artificial flavors, carrageenan, sucralose, which is like Splenda, acesulfame potassium, which is another non-nutritive sweetener, aka a zero calorie sweetener. So this is very similar to, you know, the other liquid. It just doesn't have sugar. It has a couple of those non-nutritive sweeteners. And this one even has more stabilizers and more thickeners, whatever, to give it that creamy consistency. AKA, this is less natural. So it's not gonna be creamy on its own, so they need to add a bunch of stuff in order to create that cohesive, creamy consistency. Same as the other one as well, but this one is even more processed, I guess you could say. So basically, that is just a quick rundown of the ingredient list and the nutrition facts for both the sugar-free and regular coffee creamer. But now, my favorite part of these videos is I'm just gonna kind of bring it back down to earth a little bit and put it all of this into perspective. So, in order to do that, I brought some half and half with me as well. So half and half, along with milk, of course, is definitely like the alternative to these sweet creamers. I would say people either use something like half and half or milk to add to their coffee, or something like a processed creamer. This seems to be like the other go-to option if you are going to add something to your coffee. So just to put everything into perspective, so let's compare the regular coffee creamer to just a little bit of half and half. So for one tablespoon of this, it's 35 calories. One tablespoon of this, it's 20 calories. So I'm not gonna split hairs over 15 calories, it doesn't matter. But I just wanted to point that out because some people may be like, oh, well, that's so much fat, I'm not gonna add all that fat to my coffee. And in reality, it's 1.5 grams of fat and 3 grams of fat. Again, 1.5 grams of fat, that's splitting hairs, it's nothing. If you wanna have something to make your coffee more rich and creamy, and you go to this by default because you just think it's a lot lighter and a lot healthier and less fat, it's really not. I mean, they're really not very different. And even if, say, you wanted to add a pack of sugar is usually around 15 calories. Again, nothing. So if you added a tablespoon of half and half and one packet of sugar, that would be, guess what, 35 calories, the exact same amount of calories you get in one serving of this. So you can use a little bit of half and half and sugar to make your coffee more creamy and more sweet, and in a much more natural way than if you were to go for this. And I understand some people might really just like these different flavors, they get excited about it, you know, different holidays do like pumpkin or peppermint or whatever. But I mean, at the end of the day, like, it's just a cup of coffee in the morning. It's not really meant to be a dessert. So I think you're better off just cutting out all of the crap that comes along with these processed creamers and just use a little bit of half and half or a little bit of milk and some sugar, and then it's still gonna taste good. It's still gonna be a nice, creamy, hot, sweet drink in the morning. But I just wanted to compare the two of these because I feel like some people might just automatically say, oh, I'm not gonna put cream or half and half in my coffee because it's got fat in it and a lot of calories. But when you actually look at the two together, it's like barely any different. If anything, I think this is the better choice.
Yes.
This only has 20 calories per tablespoon. This has 35. If you did a tablespoon of this plus a packet of sugar, it would be the exact same as this. And also, even if you wanted to do two tablespoons of half and half and two sugar packets, that would still only be 70 calories, and 70 calories is really not that much. So if you think about in your grand scheme of your whole day, you know, the average person needs around 2,000 calories, 70 calories is nothing. So if you want to just maybe cut out all of the crap and gunk and God knows what else that comes along with these creamers, and you can still have an amazingly creamy, delicious coffee in the morning just using some cream and sugar. I mean, you don't need to necessarily go for these, you know, because they're lighter and healthier and maybe sugar-free or fat-free. I mean, it's really just, it's not worth, like, you know, just all the crap that comes with it. So of course, in the end, how you make your coffee is completely up to you. But if you're curious about what my two cents is on the topic, I would say throw out these processed creamers. It's just not worth all of the crap that comes along with them. You can easily, you know, make your coffee creamy and sweet by just using a little bit of half and half and sugar. And it can either be the same calories and similar amount of fat, or maybe just a little bit more. But again, think about big picture, think about your whole day. If it's only 70 calories, I mean, that's really not that much. If you really love your coffee made that way, then just do it. You're probably gonna burn off half those calories making the coffee. I mean, seriously, like, just always take a step back and think big picture. Think about what you want to put into your body, and do you necessarily need to skip out on 30 calories and get a bunch of additives and stabilizers and thickeners along with it? That's how you gotta think about it. So that is all I have for this video. I hope that you guys enjoyed the Skinny On coffee creamers. And let me know down in the comment section below if you have come across a less processed, maybe more healthy creamer. I saw a couple other options in the store when I was looking at these, like ones made out of coconut milk and different things like that. And I'm just curious if you guys have tried them and, you know, what your thoughts are, because that would definitely be a better alternative. But I wanted to go for like the classic coffee creamer for this video. Also, personally, I just don't really like my coffee really sweet. I prefer it bitter, which is why I haven't, you know, gone and tried all these different kinds. So let me know, those of you who do enjoy coffee creamers in your coffee, let me know what ones you have found that maybe are healthier, and that way I can let people know to try them, and also other people down in the comment section maybe can get some other ideas. So Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Definitely give it a thumbs up if you learned something from it and if you want to share it with other people so they can hear this information as well. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I make new videos very often and I really enjoy sharing this information with you guys. So again, thank you so much for watching this video and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!
Take me higher, higher than I've ever been. We can wander all the way to the top. I'll hold on to every word you've ever said. Don't you let me down.